Last evening, President Museveni instructed the Vice President, Jessica Alupo, to meet teachers over the continued sit-down strike. As instructed, Alupo, together with some officials from the Ministry of Education and Security, today met the teachers' leadership of Uganda National Teachers Union and the National Organization of Trade Union at the office of the President in the meeting, which was closed to the media. This meeting took over 3 hours as the officials thoroughly discussed the issue of salary enhancement and the likely implications for the segregated increments. From the office of the president, the teachers proceeded to their offices at the teachers' house in Kampala, where they held a crisis meeting with some of the members of parliament for the workers, which still was closed to the media. Gilbert Baguma, the secretary general for the teachers under the umbrella body of UNATU, said that they were happy for the government to have allowed to renegotiate with them, but still in the meeting with the vice president, they have not come to any conclusion.
And now what is called win-win situation, where government is saying, okay, we are coming out of this, maybe financial year we are going to get this, and this is what is still. So you cannot just go in a negotiation and come out with nothing. But the vice president says she was also sent by the president, she's going to communicate and come back to UNATU.
Asha Wilson Owere, the Chairman General for the National Organization of Trade Unions, insisted that it's very wrong for some government officials to make threats to the striking teachers.
Came out very clearly and said now what they want is the 550 billion, which is supposed to cater for the other teachers and other workers, and also implementation of CBA, which is very, very clear that the CBA was something which was agreed by government and workers.
This Friday, officials from the Ministry of Public Service will further engage the teachers to see that they come to an agreement so that they can resume work. Report by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.